Mammals use grooming to connect socially with others. They also snuggle up together for warmth and comfort. Regardless of any responsiveness, there is a comfort in the proximity of another person's body, the gentle rise and fall of their abdomen, the warmth and feel of their skin are reassuring. Before we continue, please click the subscribe button and hit the notification bell. In the early days of a romance, lovemaking is an expression of a couple's love for each other. Sex is only a small part of the quality time they spend together. A woman views intercourse as a lovemaking act where a man demonstrates his sexual admiration for her, his ability to be aroused by her body, and his sex drive, ability to impregnate her. But over time, men tend to become engrossed in their daily pursuits and sex is taken for granted. Men fail to appreciate that women want a relationship and not sex directly. When a man dedicates non-sexual time to showing an interest in a woman and that he cares for her beyond sex, a woman feels motivated to demonstrate her affection by offering sex. A woman ideally hopes for a loving partner to enjoy sharing affection and intimate communication. She enjoys the emotional reassurance of having a partner's support and protection. She enjoys the reflected glory and pride in his achievements. A woman is not aroused by sexual activity, so she needs to feel very positively towards a man and trust him to offer sex. Without an emotional connection, even the idea of sex is disgusting to her. Sex involves a woman allowing a man to touch, kiss, and penetrate her most private anatomy. Women are revolted, not aroused by, the genitals and body fluids that men enjoy. Sex involves a serious emotional commitment for most women. When a woman is attracted to a man she admires, she is flattered that he wants intercourse with her. She feels emotionally exhilarated by the idea that he is aroused by her body and wants to penetrate her. When men are attracted to a woman, they seem to assume that a woman automatically reciprocates their feelings as if women have no responses of their own. This may be because the male sex drive causes men to convince themselves of a partner's amenability or because men objectify people who arouse them. A woman allows a man to make love to her. She has a choice, so it's not about being dominated. It's about allowing, inviting, and welcoming. This emotional reward is much stronger than simply going along with what a man wants. A woman can enjoy a sense of longing, wanting to be loved, enjoying being desired sexually. She wants to matter to him so that he will care for her. She lets him penetrate her body for his own gratification. An affectionate female lover enjoys giving pleasure when a man pleases her in other ways. Her reward is his gratitude for sexual release. Men show this gratitude by subsidizing a woman's lifestyle and pleasing her in other ways. A woman obtains an emotional payback from sex that men don't get. She feels loved and needed because of the pleasure a man gets from her body. These emotions are not sexual, involving arousal and orgasm, but they are just as vital to a woman feeling emotionally connected to a lover as the sexual emotions based on arousal and orgasm that a man experiences. A woman's inclination to offer sex is not just generosity on her part. It is also a selfish behavior because she knows that by offering sex she will gain more control in the relationship. A woman can be much more sure of a man's interest in her once a relationship transitions from platonic to sexual. When a woman is in a sexual relationship with a man, she can expect more in return than she would if they had a platonic relationship. When a woman shows initiative, for example by caressing or kissing a man, he assumes that she is aroused. But her demonstration of affection is purely platonic and is not sexually motivated. Ironically, it is her desire to demonstrate her affection that encourages a man's sex drive. This is why many women stop being affectionate over time, because they learn that their demonstrations of affection are interpreted as a sexual invitation by men. A woman has emotional needs just as a man does. But these emotional needs are not met through orgasm. Some women want to express the sense of connection they feel from sex. Women may define their emotional needs in terms of arousal and orgasm because this is how men relate to the concept of emotional connection. This is an attempt to be taken seriously by men who tend to define all adult intimacy in terms of sexual responses. A man is sexually attracted to a woman. His sex drive causes him to be highly proactive about seeking intercourse with women he is attracted to. Women do not experience this sexual drive. Women feel an emotional attachment to others. This sometimes builds up slowly if a man is devoted to her. Women are also attracted to men and fall in love. But women have no control over persuading a man to reciprocate their feelings because this relies on his sexual responses. Women can only hope and dream. Romance involves a passive behavior based on emotional responses, including anticipation and waiting that does not appeal to men. Women enjoy romance novels for the poignancy of the emotional reward they feel when they identify with how a woman feels when a man reciprocates her love. Tell her she's important to you. For a woman to feel the desire for sex, she needs to feel loved, adored, and significant. Allen and Barbara Pease, 1999. Excerpt from learnaboutsexuality.org. Thank you for watching.